one of the team leaders, managers, I think had spoken to John Pearman, who's putting on the night previously. We've done some printing for him before, and he happened to mention that he was starting this night, and he had this space in his club, which there is in Southend, and he wanted to decorate the space so it didn't look like Chinneries in Southend, like exactly how it is, you know, for the night. It looked a bit special for the night.
The two of having like an alternative indie DJ with alternative indie bands and make it one big night, we felt there was a gap in the market for that, definitely.
Yeah. And the other thing, going to a gig is great, but the next stage from actually not being on stage yourself is, why don't we put a gig on? And that was the next thing. We love doing this, so why don't we try the next stage of putting something on ourselves? So what's the best place we can go to? What's the best gigs we can put on? So once we decided on this, it was a matter then of trying to get hold of bands, which is a lot easier now than it was 6 months ago. But 6 months ago, it's really hard to get hold of people. And we got very lucky with the first two bands. We got through, they both could do it at a certain time. And once they both said yes, it was then off we go. We had to get all the branding together. Again, we didn't want to, we come to Chinneries a lot. So walking in Chinneries front door, coming into this gig, we wanted to have it a little bit more pizzazzy. You know, it's Indie Cold Club night tonight. So it was then a matter of coming up with the logo. The logo had to be something.
Remember our first logo, one that we designed. It was awful, awful.
It was very, very true.
Thankfully, we got.
Yeah, because nowadays you think you can actually play with these things online, but actually, again, you can't. Not to come up with something that's got something.
Remember that.
We were fortunate in having Isaac, who's a designer, and he chatted about the sort of thing we might have wanted. He came up with it, and to be fair, he came up with no other ideas. It was this one idea, basically said, take this or leave it, but I think this is really good. Fortunately, we all liked it.
Yeah.
This idea of this sort of the cult in the middle here is this cassette. So the indie music is known for its 90s
C-90s.
Form. Yeah. So this in the middle is taking the eye out and putting a cassette, and obviously it creates some kind of cult sort of look.
So once you've got a good logo, you know, it's a good logo, so you can put it on anything and it'll look great. So Chinneries is painted black pretty much inside throughout, and he just wanted a series of boards that were going to be black with the logo on, you know, to go at the, you know, the ticket desk, the merch stand, and like to cover up certain things he didn't want. So it was just about creating those kind of few ideas, you know, because obviously we do a lot of products that are good for like decorating spaces, like the wall clings, the window stickers, things like that. So trying to incorporate some of those, done some wall clings, which can you can put them on the wall, or in this case pillars, and there's no glue, and then you can just peel them off, because obviously the club is used for other events outside. So that's what I enjoyed about it. It was like thinking about the space and the products and how we can use it.
We were very lucky to have Chinna has allowed us to put up Home of Indie Cult Club outside the front door, which I think you'll see.
Not to just be another Chinnery's gig, we wanted the punters out there to see all the logos everywhere. We've got a big sign on the front door, just as you walk in by the ticket booth, Indie Cult Club. Obviously the Home of Indie Cult Club outside, all over the place. The logo and the brand name is everywhere, so people know it's an Indie Cult Club night.
We wanted to bring back a ticket. Now, we know you can, but you don't ideally when we send tickets out to people. So first thing we thought, well, when they come in, can they walk away with a ticket? It's quite a nice thing to have when you come to a gig, because Richard and I just went off in this way, because he was a big gig guy. You know, he understood a lot of the things. He was kind of feeling how we were things. So I knew we were in good hands when Richard started talking. So that was a good idea.
Well, thankfully, if you look at any of the like classic, what I'd call classic, right? Classic tickets from that kind of last moment of, you know, like kind of before the internet was, you know, like it is now. like, they're not really like that. When you actually look at them, obviously as I had to, they're almost like, the background is almost like a kind of cheesy Shutterstock certificate. Yeah, like it's something like that. And the logos are just plonked on there. And it's kind of got, a kind of quite a rough and ready feel, or even though a lot of these bands are like quite prestigious bands, you know, but if you're playing, you know, especially the stuff in the Brixton Academy, so it was kind of nice trying to recreate that. So, you know, I got that background by using elements of the logo, you know, overlapping, low opacity, that sort of thing. And you just put one logo on top and then plus support, you know. But it works. And when you see the ticket, that is exactly what it looks like. And again, printed it on a pulp board, on the uncoated stock, because that's the feel of the original kind of tickets in perforation on there and everything.
Another idea was that if you collected four tickets, you can get all the stubs off, you can get £10 off of merchandise. So on the back of the ticket, Richard came up with this idea of, we'll form that triangle on the back of the ticket. So when you've got four, if you wanted to, as a part of a collection, you can put them together and it will form this triangle. Thank you much, really, again. So Richard took over in terms of getting everything together. So Solopress are very quick. You know, you can usually, if you're something on the Monday, it's done by Wednesday.
Oh, I love them. They're great. Very professional. They look great. They really look great in the club. I don't think we could have gotten any better.
Right, so yeah, we couldn't be happier, really.
No, it's great.